Hello students, I will start with the chapter Europe in this video. So Europe is a continent that comprises the westernmost peninsula of Eurasia. Eurasia means Europe and Asia together. Okay, it is the sixth largest continent of the world. It is the birthplace of Western culture. Industrial Revolution began in Europe in the 18th century. The European history, then culture, then economy, then social and political aspect have greatly influenced the people of the world. This also paved the way or paved the path for the European colonization in almost every continent. Colonization means the European, means most of the European countries have set up colonies and their own colonies in most of the continent of the world. For example, the British came to India, then the Spanish and the French has the colonies in the American portion. So in this way, it settled a colony or have colonization or paved the path of the colonization in every continent. Next is the location, the latitudinal and the longitudinal extension of the Europe is, the latitudinal extent is 35 degree north to 72 degree north, and the longitudinal extension is 25 degree west to 65 degree east. So this is the map, you can see. So Europe is located in the western portion of Asia. This is Asia, and based on the location, it is located in the western section of the Asia. It is in fact the large peninsular part of the great landmass called the Eurasia. You have learned about, or you know about the Eurasia, you have studied about the Eurasia in the chapter Asia, when this two continent, that is the Europe and the Asia, we together call this as the Eurasia. Okay, so this Europe is the larger peninsular part of this great landmass that we call or generally termed as the Eurasia. So based on the latitudinal extent, and it extends from 35 degree north. So you can see this is 35 degree north over here. So it is extending from 35 degree north to 72. You can see 75 over here. So up just beside the 75, so in between this, the 72 degree north is present. So up to here, that is the latitudinal extent of the Europe, and the longitudinal extent is from 25 degree west to 65 degree east. So this is 20, so you can see 25 degree west, so it is extending up to, this is here, it up to 50 is mentioned. So apart from the 50, in between this 50 and 70 and the 50, here lies the 65 degree east. Okay, so the most of the portion of the Europe lies in the temperate zone. You can see the Arctic Circle present over here. So and it lies and the no tropics is actually passing through this continent, so it falls under the temperate zone, and the places which are above this Arctic Circle will have the frigid zone or falls in this frigid zone. So most of the continent of the Europe actually lies in the temperate zone. Only a small area or small section of the Europe which lies beyond this Arctic Circles falls in the frigid zone and experience extreme type of the climate. Okay, next is the area and extent. So the Europe is an elongated in shape, and in the east-west direction with a large number of the peninsulas. It is about 5,400 kilometer long in the 5,400 kilometer long in the east-west direction, and about 5,050 kilometer long in the north-south direction. Thus, the continent covers a total area of about 10,55,000 square kilometer. It is the size of this Europe is about 3 times the size of the India. So the size and the extent of the Europe is about 3 times the size of the India, and it is the second smallest continent, and it is the sixth largest continent of the world. Only the size of the Australia is smaller than the Europe. Apart from that, every other continent has greater than the Europe. So it is the sixth largest continent of the world. So this is the end of this video. I'll continue with the next of the portion in the next video. Thank you, everyone.